sales quadrant today, you really need to look at copper, up 4.3% in toward the close. Biggest point move in one single session that I've seen since May of 2013. That's about as far back as I went. There were a couple of days that came close, but this was the biggest one. You rallied up over 15 cents in the CME contract for copper. So a very big move amounting to 4.3% change on the day from yesterday. Now, a lot of it was driven by the risk asset rally, of which copper is one. Stocks had a huge day, stoking optimism that we might be finally seeing a bottom in the equity market fall, at least. Economically, it's different. We had some pretty bad PMI numbers out of Europe, historically bad PMI out of the US as well, although this particular series of PMI figures only started in 2014. There's not a ton of data that it's going against. A copper rally back on some of the optimism for a Senate stimulus package and the statement from the G7 that they were going to do everything they could to return the global economy back to the growth side of the spectrum. So copper took a day off from the sell-off that we've seen. Now, lastly, when you're looking at the stocks having a huge day, you have to look at the dollar pullback as well. We're finally getting a little bit of a pullback in that dollar index, down 1% on the lows, finishing down a little bit more than 2/3 of 1%. We've had 11 up sessions in the dollar index. Three of those have been negative. The other eight have been up and up big. And today was the only down day that kind of matched the exuberance to the upside. But overall, in the copper market, because of the volume, it looked like short covering. In the dollar index, it looked like long liquidation, neither one of which should necessarily be sustainable unless we do get a stimulus package and specific plans from the G7, as well as, again, the flattening out of infection curve in the U.S., Italy, the way that they've had it in South Korea.